Bismillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome everyone to Amazed by the Qur'an, a series in which I like talking about what I find amazing about the Qur'an. Today I'll explain the difference, a subtle difference between two ayat, one belonging to Suratul Ma'idah, the fifth surah, and the other to Suratul Taghabun, the 64th surah. Very similar. Wa ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger. That's identical in both of them. Wa ahdharu, and be careful, watch out. Fa in tawallaytum, then if you were to turn away, فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا عَلَى رَسُولِنَا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ, then you had better know that our messenger's responsibility is only to deliver the message clearly. وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا رَسُولِنَ, Surah Al-Taghabun, obey Allah and obey the messenger. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ, then if you were to turn away, فَإِنَّمَا عَلَى رَسُولِنَا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ, then our messenger's only responsibility is to deliver a clear message. So they both seem to be saying obey Allah and obey the messenger, except in Ma'idah, Allah adds, and be careful. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger. وَحْذَرُوا, and be careful. So the question arises, why is Allah telling us to be careful in Ma'idah and not so much in Surah Al-Taghabun? You'll notice in Surah Al-Taghabun, it's a sermon and it doesn't have any commandments. And we're not given anything to watch out for. Anything to be careful about in particular. So Allah does not add, be careful. But if you study Surah Al-Ma'idah, just the ayat before, this is ayah number 92, I'll read to you something from ayah number 90 and 91. Listen up. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, those of you who have iman, innama al-khamr wal-maisir wal-ansab wal-azlam rijsum min amal ash-shaytan. You had better know that wine, intoxicants, gambling, altars, you know, places to do particular rituals. So ansab is not just altars, but it's any kind of ritual that you do to, you know, make your life better and things like that. People put amulets and all kinds of fun stuff and, you know, do morning rituals or have you know, these kinds of practices. Drop all of those. Well, azlam. Azlam was, you know, casting lots and arrows, but what it means actually is doing stuff for good luck. Good luck charms or going to a palm reader or something. All this stuff counts under azlam, okay? So he says, alcohol, gambling, these weird rituals, I'll make it easy, weird rituals, and then doing things for good luck. All of them, رِجْسُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ, these are abominations, filth from the work of the devil. فَجْتَنِبُوا, stay away from all of it. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, so you could be successful. إِنَّمَا يُرِدُ الشَّيْطَانِ أَنْ يُوقِعَ بَيْنَكُمُ الْعَدَاوَةَ وَالْبَغْضَاءِ, Shaitan, all he wants is that he install between you and drop between you animosity and hatred. فِي الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ, by using alcohol and gambling. That's pretty serious. وَيَصُدُّكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, and moreover, he wants to prevent you from remembering Allah, وَعَنِ الصَّلَاةِ, and he wants to prevent you from prayer itself. فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُنْتَهُونَ, then are you going to stop or what? Then he says, obey Allah and obey the Messenger and be careful. He said, be careful because there's lots of things to watch out for in the previous ayah. There isn't a long list of instructions of the tricks of shaitan. By the way, when it comes to shaitan, he gets you to do things when you're not careful. So it's important to mention at that point, not just obey Allah and obey the Messenger, but also add, wahdharu, be careful. The perfection, once again, of what needs to be said at what occasion. This is actually pretty good, you know, tip, and a very powerful divine tip for a da'i, for someone who's speaking and giving advice to someone. When should you emphasize something? When should you not emphasize something? When is it the time to speak less and when is it a time to speak more? Sometimes you have a lot on your mind, you want to get it all out, but you should sense this is not the right time. This is given the subject matter, I don't need to emphasize it as much. It might take away from the idea of emphasis. You know, when people emphasize something all the time, then it loses its emphasis. If people are yelling all the time, it doesn't sound as loud anymore. You know, if people are angry all the time, people get used to their anger. They're not fazed by it anymore. So you have to turn it up sometimes. And take it down a few notches sometimes. That's what the Qur'an does. That's why the Qur'an's ayat are compared to the breeze. Some breezes are strong, some are soft, some are warm, some are cold. This is what Allah does. He'll give the same advice, but given the situation and the audience and the subject matter at hand, He might intensify it or He might take it back. He might tone it down, subhanAllah. And that's the wisdom of Allah's speech. May Allah Azza wa Jalla help us embody that kind of wisdom in our own speech. Barakallahu li wa lakum, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.